Salute comrades and welcome back to Let's Play Victoria 2. My name is Vadim and we are doing the next video for Victoria 2. In this video something special awaits you, and in this video we will try to invade Great Britain. Since last video it was a year or so, and I've managed to get some influence on China. The reason for war will be the situation I have with this country, Gwilor. I get an event that allowed me to have a casus belli on them, and I've asked for a military military access, yes, from Great Britain, and because I have good relations with them, they let me do this, so I will start. Start this thing. Yeah. Start this war, and later I hope United Kingdom will join this war. Because, guys, I know this, because this happened when I first time played, so I just loaded the save game, so just to show you guys how it went. So, actually, this country, Gwalior, it's a very close friend with Great Britain, so, so suck for them. And actually we are preparing our forces of invasion. Let's see. I want to get my best guys on this boat, so I will have to find them first. Find the generals that I like the most. This guy. Yeah, you will be in the first. And you. Okay, I guess that's it. I do not have much of generals right now, and the ones that I have are not that great. About research, I have reached the breech loaded rifles, and I start go for imperialism. And actually, I've changed my administration to a military industrial complex, and right now I am not so glad that I did that, because the thing I will research in a like for the next, I don't know, maybe 10 years is not military, not so much military and industrial. I will concentrate on culture and maybe some fleet because of this. thing. Let's wait a sec, attraction. Do not want. Yeah, guys, you just wait. So our goal is to taint Great Britain, so maybe even try to decrease our relationships with them, so they would do it quicker. And we need to add a war goal, like we can add war goal to annex Gwalior, and it's actually a very important country, because it their province, its province have a production of dye, and dye is a thing that limits my clothes production. Yeah, so okay, finally we have take, and yeah, Great Britain immediately declare war on us. And the next thing I'm going to do is, it will be a little bit strange, I'm going to disband all of my colonial troops. Let's see, I need to make sure nothing is being built here. So I'm getting rid of this one. Let's see, getting rid of this ones. That one, yeah, they pretty large forces, but like actually to build them once again, it's not that big of a deal. But the thing I'm doing this is because in this game, in Victoria 2, battles are more important than capture provinces, and if I would keep them. Then I would, and I lose battles, I would lose a pretty big amount of war score, yeah, like 1 or 2 points per battle. And if there will be no battles, only they will capture my provinces, it wouldn't be like almost anything. They would get like the fraction of a percent for that, and that's exactly what I'm planning. And by the way, their provinces will cost much more than their core provinces will cost much more than my colonial provinces. So okay, yeah, we've reached shore. Let's see, who is my most best defending general? My best defending general goes here. Then attack, defense. He goes here, goes here. And yeah, that should do it. I'm hoping just that Britons will not come with a great fleet all of a sudden. Let's see, it's a small frigate. It's my 62 men of war will just beat it easily. And yeah, I forgot to start buying clippers again, because without them it's not that cool. So let's check my best general, my other general. Actually, it's better for him to... Oh, this is... So, we will cover this order. And actually, we will... It will be lots of time for us to capture provinces, but we just need to defeat their army. And one cool trick, we need to surround our opponent, and no, I think he would be able to go to Belfast in worst case scenario for him. Let's need, so we have a plus 4 to our battle plan. And as we see, he loses lots of guys, lots of people. And I really need to reinforce mines. So maybe I will even get these guys. And I'm not scared of somebody attack me, because I have... Oh, I guess this guy will be enough. Actually, if their big army will go that direction, it's better, because it's easier for my guys to defend later on. Okay, and let's bring more troops. Six more. And yeah, I have a money problem, so... Yeah, and I wanted to restore Academia, and have a money problem, so I should raise tariffs. Raise some taxes. And make sure all of my Clipper Convoy factories are operating, because it's the most important thing right now. Yeah, most expensive thing for me is the Clipper Convoys. And all military factories are important right now, so I need to open them all. Okay, they're back. Oh my god, I left the wrong general. Yeah, I need the reinforcements like really, really fast. And okay, thanks God I won, but I need to get rid of this stupid general. He will ruin everything for me. And finally, guys, glad to see you. Okay, and I hope I can, like, let's see. If I can surround my opponent, that means all of his army is destroyed. My guys was in this province before his guys, so he... should be okay. Right now I am completely surround him, if of course he cannot move through this territory. So if it's true, then his army will be destroyed right now. So okay, our next goal is state government, and then nationalism and imperialism, and that's these two technologies. And I guess he do not have armies anymore, and yeah, all his army is destroyed. So it's time for us to start capturing his provinces, like on a very, very uncool, in a very uncool manner. Because I've destroyed his army, I think I will not need any more of troops. And I will have... And this one, this is enough. Let's see... I have a terrible attrition problem, because I do not yet have any captured provinces, but once I do... this problems will be solved pretty much, like more or less, but still. And I split my army to cover more territory. Let's see the war score. Yeah, it's already in my... at my side, so... actually, I do not need anything from this small country. I need... some province, United Kingdom province. There is a... if you want to capture some... English provinces, it's better to go for highlands or lowlands, because they are pretty unimportant. And they have ports, yeah, lots of ports. Another one, for instance, North East England, or Birmingham. Let's see what is the price of Birmingham. or how it's called, Midlands, yeah.
Midlands.
34. But I would definitely want to go for Lowlands for now. Because Edinburgh is a pretty nice looking city. And yeah, we the thing we need to do is to oh my god, they, I think they landed some forces additional. So that's what would be suck for me. I think this battle will not be as cool as I thought. Okay, they once again tried to take China from my influence, and I just banned their embassy. And by the way, let's see if any of our allies want to join our war. And I do not want to use like this weak allies, but I want to. Okay, Ottomans, do you want it? Yeah, they 100. Great. Because when it's maybe, it's usually means that they will decline. So where were we? So maybe I will lose these troops. And it's okay, actually. Because what you really need to do is to defend Glasgow. Because it's they will be able to attack you from Glasgow. Let's try to retreat. Actually, we lost a lot. And yeah, because they had a fleet in this area, I'm not able to retreat, and my brave general will die. Very tragic death. Oh no, I will just disband this unit, and nothing bad will happen. Okay, guys, I think right now it's pretty boring, so I guess that would be it for this video. As you see, we invaded United Kingdom, and we will finish it off in the next video. But for today, that's it. Thank you for watching, and comrades, you are dismissed.